it's going to have 4 songs. It's a praise and worship session. Amen. Be blessed.
Thank you.
Oh Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all thy works thy hands have made, I see the stars.
Then sings my soul, how great thou art.
Yes.
Look and live. Look and live.
have a message from the Lord. Hallelujah. A message unto you I'll give. Tis recorded in his words. Hallelujah. It's only that you look and live. Look and live. Look and live, my brother, live. Look to Jesus now and live. Tis recorded in his words. Hallelujah. It's only that you look. Look and live, my brother, live. Look to Jesus now and live. 'Tis recorded in his words. Hallelujah. It's only that you look and live.
Next song. My brother, because I was were debating about this song, either Encha and Nunji, it is in our local language, or Rodown. But now, before Encha and Nunji, let us perform this song, Rodown.
chariot, let me ride.
My brother,
roll down the chariot, let me ride.
My sister,
roll down the chariot, let me ride. Roll down the chariot, let me ride. Roll down the chariot, let me ride.
My brother,
roll down the chariot, let me ride.
My sister,
roll down the chariot, let me ride.
Why don't you
roll down the chariot, let me ride.
Ride on,
ride on, King Jesus.
Oh, ride on,
ride on, King Jesus.
Ride on,
ride on, the conquering King. I wanna go to heaven in the morning.
Ride on,
ride on, King Jesus.
Ride on,
King Jesus.
Ride on,
ride on, the conquering King. I wanna go to heaven in the morning.
I've been trying so hard just to make it through. And I try to live where you want me to. I wanna say goodbye to all the things inside.
Thank you so much. The next song, which is the last one, it's entitled Encha Enunji. Encha Enunji, it simply tells us that there's a bright morning when we shall meet our Lord Jesus Christ. How many of us believe that we shall meet him in the clouds? God bless you as you listen to this song, Encha Enunji.
Encha enunji esembete eya twagale nyo era kukoma bombo ela chisache fokuba ye watali tuliba fu echa enunji
eyo
esebete eya twagale nyo
era
kukomabo ela chisache okubawo
ye
watari tuli bafu
tulivuga
wa
Jesus Christ came and died for us.
Isn't it?
Repeat it. You can repeat that high note, sir.
In deep or in high?
In a deep.
In a deep.
Yes, sir.
Ooh.
In high, in high.
Ooh.
Yes.
Twafuna mu Yesu. Yes, sir.
Do you know how to sing solo fuzz?
I'm going to try in Jesus' name. Yes.
Do, ti, da, so.
Do, do.
Thank you.
Jesus watching again. Jesus watching again. Nia ki mere ekelele dirigi. Nia ki mere ekelele 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 dirigi. Jesus watching again.
Thank you so much.
Rush on the sea, they roll on the wall. Great is the army that carries out his word. They rush on the sea, they roll on the wall. Great is the army that carries out his word. The Lord of the peoples before his army. The Lord of the peoples before his army. They rush on the sea, they roll on the wall. Great is the army that carries out his word. They rush on the sea, they roll on the wall. Great is the army that carries out his word. The Lord of the peoples before his army. Holy mountain, blow the trumpet in Zion, Zion. Shout it aloud. Blow the trumpet in Zion, Zion. Shout it aloud in my holy mountain. Blow the trumpet in Zion, Zion. Shout it aloud. Blow the trumpet in Zion.
Anymore. I can't hear you. Say, we shall not die anymore. So what do? We hang out the banners. Say to yourself, I will hang out the banner. And I will not die anymore. Hallelujah.
Children and dance with me, oh, sing to our living King.
the spirit and the soul. Join hands, let your voices ring. Christ is the risen Lord. Celebration for what he has done. Jesus, your Lord, sets you free. Jesus, your Lord, sets you free. Jesus, your Lord, sets you free.
Hallelujah. How many people would like to join with me and say hallelujah?
Amen. At this point, we'd like to recognize some dignitaries in our midst. First, we'd like to recognize our father, His Royal Highness, the Gbongbonjos, and Jacob Buba. You're welcome, sir. We also like to welcome Bibi Nabasu and wife. You're welcome, sir. We also have members of the diplomatic corps in our midst. We have the High Commissioner of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, Wendell DeLandro. You're welcome, sir. Thank you for being part of this. You're welcome. God bless you. We also have Edda Hope Thompson and wife. You're welcome, sir. God bless you. Thank you for being part of this. We also have Barrister Yusuf Damadami from ECOWAS. You're welcome, sir. Can you wave at us? God bless you. Thank you for being part of this. We also have Major General Musa Damadami from Defense Headquarters. You're welcome, sir. Thank you very much for being part of this session.
And I would like to take the opportunity to welcome our viewers joining us via social media. I would like to specially welcome our viewers who are listening in from Trinidad and Tobago. We know we have viewers listening from the UK and as far as the USA as well. We welcome you. I would like to encourage us to continue to share the link so that persons who are not able to join us in person can enjoy what we are enjoying and be blessed, because the ministry, it's all about ministry, lifting up the name of our Lord and Savior. I would like to congratulate you who have been sharing and to also let you know that we are trending number 2 on Twitter. It's good.
Amazing, yes. Amazing, amazing.
Yes.
Glory be to God.
It's about time we have some positive trends on social media. So continue to share, continue. Remember, the hashtag and the handles are IPC2022, all in lowercase, and Asokoro SDA Church.
Thank you very much. Well, at this point, we're going to take the keynote address. Speaking to us one more time is Pastor Professor Kevin Onoga, the Vice-Chancellor of Adventist University, of Central Africa, all the way from Kigali, Rwanda. Pastor Kevin, God bless you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and all the dignitaries here present. I believe that all protocols have been observed. It's wonderful to be back here and to see the auditorium full, this full. For the next few minutes, I'd like to speak to you briefly on this topic I've entitled, When Justice and Mercy Kiss. You will agree with me that from Kiev in Ukraine to Kaduna, Nigeria, perhaps the most sought after commodity is peace. Peace, though sought after, is so elusive. Indeed, we can ask the question, what is peace? Maybe you could find different ways to define peace, but I would like to picture peace. What image comes to your mind as you think about peace? I remember a greeting card I saw many years ago. The greeting card was made by a mother who took a picture of the sleeping children and she titled it Peace on Earth. Peace on Earth because no noise with the children. How many of you, by the way, have infants, children? How many? Let me see the hands of those who have infant children that keep you awake. Amen. You know, the ones that were born at night, late in the night. And so 2 a.m. is when day breaks for them. So the mother took a picture and put it, peace on earth. That is peace for her. Another image that comes to my mind is that of a suckling child at the breast of the mother. I can't find a more beautiful image of peace than that. That child is content. Let the earthquake, let storms rage, let mountains collapse, as long as mom is there and breast milk is assured, peace. How about you? What is peace to you? You see, peace will be defined by your situation and your circumstances. Are you a married man who has a shrew for a wife? Peace on earth is when she's not around, isn't it? How about the woman who has an abusive husband? Who the moment he comes into the home, everybody scatters and scampers. Peace on earth is when that abusive lion is not around. How about you? What is peace to you? What does peace mean to you? Peace means a lot of different things to a lot of us. So, again, I ask the question, what is peace? Is peace about a place? You know, I remember some time ago, I had the privilege of going for a program somewhere in Spain, and I sent a picture to my sister who had been there. One of the most expensive places where you have the mansions of, you know, movie stars and all these greats, artists and celebrities. And so I sent her a picture and she said, no, you just took a picture, it doesn't mean you are there. Show me a selfie that you were there. Well, I wish you could see the beach of this beautiful place. The beach is turquoise green, sand white and clear. It's as if it came out of not just the magazine, you know, from the time when God created it. That's how beautiful it looked. So tell me, is peace a place? Is peace found in possessions? Is peace found in a position? Because there are some today who are thinking, if I don't become president of this country, is peace about a position? You know, one of the guys who they discovered is just the fastest exchequer in the history of UK. Last week he was Minister of Finance as rare for the UK. Today is what? He's out of office. Last week he thought he'd read the prime of his career, isn't it? So what is peace to you? A position? A place? Possessions? Until you and I come to realize that peace is not found in possessions, positions, or place, but in a person, we'll be going round and round in circles. Because there is one who is called the Prince of Peace. And without him, every effort at peace is an effort in futility. Peace is a person. So, how do you find this peace? It must be found in relationship, in connection with Jesus. He is the Prince of Peace. But like we mentioned, I don't know how many of you followed the conference we had yesterday. But we had a peace conference yesterday. And if you missed it, you can still follow on Facebook. I'm sure you still have the recordings. And next year, we'll be having another one. But one point that came out clear was, everybody wants peace. But then the question is, can we have peace without justice? Can we really have peace without justice? No justice, no peace. That's just the truth. There's an interconnection, an interrelationship between justice and peace. Indeed, it has been said that the justice of God and the righteousness of God are twin sides of the same coin. Two sides of the same coin. Romans chapter 12, verse 22 makes that very clear. Behold the severity and the mercy of God. Justice of God, the mercy of God. Let me break it down for you, in case you don't understand it. Have you ever tried getting a chick from the mother hen with a mother hen present? That is a dangerous exercise, isn't it? Because even if you are a lion, the mother hen goes for you. The mother hen doesn't care your size. Just don't mess around with her chicks. And you know, I want you to realize that in similar ways, you and I are the apple of God's eyes. Say it louder if you believe it. The apple of God's eye. Do you know what that means? The apple of your eye. Look at the person next to you. I hope it's your wife. Look at the person next to you. You see the brown or the black stuff in the middle? That's the apple of the eye. Would you imagine somebody putting a finger in your eye and you watch? What would you do? It's either you move that finger away, you move the person away, or you move away, isn't it? Uh-huh. God is saying, that is how precious you are to me. I will not allow anyone mess around with you. And that is why in order for there to be peace on earth, there must be justice too. God must deal with everyone who causes disturbance to his children, who wants to mess around with their lives, mess around with their futures. Peace and justice are intermingled. By the way, everyone agrees that injustice brings war, correct? Justice brings peace. Justice brings peace. And this evening, I want to talk about that theme briefly, about the connection between justice and peace. By the way, a Hebrew word for peace is shalom. Over 256 times in the Old Testament, you have this word shalom occurring. But too many times when people talk about shalom, they have a limited grasp or understanding of what it is all about. Shalom is not just peace as an ephemeral quality that cannot be defined or described. No, the Hebrew concept of peace is closer to the African, the Nigerian concept of peace. What do I mean? How do the Yorubas greet a person when they meet them? Prof, how do you greet a person when you meet them? She alafia ni. What we fail to realize is Alafia is a loan word from the Hausa Muslims who greet. And how do the Hausas in Alafia? Lafia, peace. But it actually comes from the Arabic word, Al-Afia. Whether it was loaned or not is not the issue. But the issue is this. There's a quest for peace in the heart of every African. And when the Igbos greet Izindu, it's still the same concept. And it's not just about peace. It's about well-being. It's about happiness. It's about safety. It's about everything being in order. And in order for that to happen, justice must happen. Laws must be observed. You know, we fail to realize that there is an extricate interconnection between us and the cosmos that we're from. And that's when we do something wrong, it affects even the ground that we're on. That's why when sin came into the world, it wasn't just restricted to Adam and Eve, but affected even the earth and the cosmos, the air they breathed, the land they walked upon, the relationship with each other. And in order for this to be restored, justice must happen. Justice. And so there's a quest for shalom, a quest for peace, but it must be also done in the context of justice. By the way, the Old Testament prophets equated justice and righteousness. What is righteousness? Righteousness, simple, right living. Living right. Live right. What does living right mean? Recognizing that you owe the other something good. You owe the environment goodness, good acts, good ways. One of the cries of the Old Testament prophets that resound throughout the ages is, let justice roll like the rivers. Let righteousness be there like the never-failing streams. The cry of the prophets. You can't say you want peace and you're ignoring the people who are around you. Some of you missed the service we had this morning. We'd like to invite you, as you come for the concert, to also follow us to worship. My aunt had this neighbor, a man who never went to sleep, always looking around to see that his house was in order, always afraid that armed robbers would attack him. My aunt, on the other hand, who at one time was known as Madame UPN. You remember UPN? You Nigerians, older ones, UPN. UPN gave birth to NPN. And NPN, long history, isn't it? One thing I respect and I remember her for, she's late now. She made sure she had water supply to her house that was never failing. And she gave instructions to a security guard. Anytime anybody comes here for water, allow them fetch the water. Open the gates, let them come and get water. She never had one incident of armed robbery. I remember many years ago, I was in Babcock, we were having a security conference. I said there, as the facilitator, the height of the wall you build is inconsequential. The burglary system that you put around the house does not matter. If the Nigerian armed robbers determine they are coming to your house, only heaven can deliver you. You know that, don't you? It was in Warri. I pastored in Warri. And we woke up one morning, that wet cement with acid, the first time in my life, I knew that the chemistry we're studying could apply that way. They poured acid on the cement and made a nice hole, came into the house and robbed the woman of all her jewelry. Said, if walls are not safe again, who is safe? Who is safe? So, you want peace? How about taking care of the people around you? How about taking care of your neighborhood? And some are saying that the origin of Boko Haram. It may not be the sole reason, because there's never anything that's a sole cause of evil. Maybe if we're taking better care of the young people who are unemployed, maybe if we're taking better care of those who were jobless, uneducated, homeless, helpless, maybe if we're taking better care of them, maybe we'll not be in the situation we are in today, where kidnapping is big business. Because the fact of the matter is, how many folks who have good jobs are out there trying to steal? How many folks who work hard from 8 to 5 have the energy to go out to carry out banditry? How many persons who have a stable future are the ones who be involved in crime or stuff like that? Justice, righteousness brings forth peace. Before I begin to close, I just want to share with you this Chinese proverb I heard recently. It said, do you want happiness? Are you in search of happiness? Anybody here in search of happiness? I can't see you. Raise the hand up if you're sure you want happiness. Okay. It said, so if you want happiness, what do you do? If you want happiness for an hour, go fishing. You want happiness for a day? It says what? If you want happiness for a day, let me take that again. If you want happiness for an hour, take a nap. Happiness for a day, go fishing. Happiness for a month, get married. You want for a year, inherit a fortune. But if you want happiness for a lifetime, help others. Help others. Help others. Happiness for a lifetime, help others. Duke University in America did a study. A study on what brings about personal peace. Among the 8 cardinal things that they found, a few I'd like to share with you today. When you surrender your will, you find peace. When you have a quiet conscience, peaceful interaction with your neighbors and those in your place of work, you have peace. When you have a loving fellowship in your community, you have peace. When you have a hopeful heart, you have peace. But even greater still, when you have a personal relationship with Jesus, you have peace. This morning I shared with you, when your life is hid with Christ in God, you have peace. Let the storms rage. Let the billows roll. Let the mountains quake. Let the pandemic continue. You have peace. Because whether you live or you die, you know your life is hid with Christ in God. And when your life is hid with Christ in God, you're safe. Because Jesus is also the resurrection and the life. How sad it is that we toil and we trouble ourselves for a lifetime of how long? How long? Folks tell me you still look young. I say, no, I'm not young. The gray hair is there, and my passport shows how old I am. I can't change that. The clock is ticking. Just yesterday, I can still remember when the children ran around. Now I have an emptiness, believe it or not. But you know what? This is not the real life. This is only a foretaste of the better life. One Christian writer I love to quote so much says, we're here on this earth on trial to see if you and I will qualify for the true life, the better life. And so the question is, how are you using your days on this earth? How are you living your life here? How are you making a difference? What are you doing in your community? Time is about up. I read this some time ago. Many years ago, over 30 years ago, Reader's Digest, it says, you and I must learn how to practice random acts of kindness and senseless acts of beauty every day. Let me take that again. Do what? Practice random acts of kindness, senseless acts of beauty every day. Do something good in the life of someone. Make your environment better, happier, brighter, more beautiful. Practice random acts of kindness, senseless acts of beauty. One musician complained in a song, a gospel musician. He said he saw all the pain and the trials and the troubles of this world, and he complained to God, God, where are you? What are you doing about all of this? And then later he said, he heard God speak to him, I created you. I created you to make a difference. I created you to find a solution. I created you to find a way around the issues about you. So, as I close this evening, I close with a text in scripture in the book of Romans chapter 8. It says, all creation groans, waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. And who are the sons of God? The sons of God who distinguish themselves as peacemakers. Those who seek to bring peace in their communities, change the lives of those around them, make a difference for the better of the people around them. Peacemakers. The world is waiting. All creation is groaning. That passage both has eschatological implications, but also has existential application. Eschatological because it's talking about when Jesus will come, when the sons of God shall become manifest, but already now we need them to be manifest. We need the sons and the daughters of God to make a difference where they are. We need them to rise up, act, work for peace, for good, for righteousness, for justice. It's time to rise. It's time to work. It's time to do good. It's time to stand and be counted. May you and I be among those who stand up for Jesus. May you and I be among those who make a difference in our communities. May you and I be among those who have good testimonies in our communities that here is a good man. Here is a good woman. As a person who made a difference to bring peace, justice, righteousness in their community. I want to be that person. I want to be that person. I want to make a difference. Look at the hands around you. Turn around. Look around you. Look up there. If each and every one of us today commits to making that difference each and every day, practicing random acts of kindness every day, senseless acts of beauty, imagine the change that would come to our world. May God help us do that. In Jesus' name.
Thank you very much, Pastor Kelvin. Can we get another round of applause for him? Wonderful message. So if we want peace, we have a great deal to play, a big part to play to ensure that there is peace. How many of us agree with me based on what Pastor Kelvin just said? Yes? For righteousness, we must have what? We must live right. How many of us want an hour of peace? Or maybe a day of peace? But I know for sure that all of us, we want a lifetime of peace. And what do we have to do to ensure that? We have to help others. Amen. As we move along, we are going to have soul max, chamber vocals, Axios, men of peace, and Jehovah Shalom. Let me just share some short information about chamber vocals. They have been together since childhood. They were officially named in 2012. They have done over 200 appearances, and they released a single in 2020, Aga Begalam. Did I get it right? I think I did. Did I? Those of you who know the song, Abba, Aga, Begalam, Begalam. They'll tell us when they come. And Axios is an award-winning chorale, and they have performed both at home and abroad. They were founded 16 years ago, and they are known for their high-energy performances. So let's, with a round of applause, welcome them onto the stage. In the order, Soul Max, Chamber Vocal, Axios, Men of Peace, and then again, Jehovah Shalom.
God rule all heaven and earth. You respond, heaven and earth. Are you with me? Let's go. Arise and give the praise to God, rule all heaven and earth. I can hear you. Oh, give him all the glory, praise thanksgiving. The Lord is good. I'm going to sing in both English and in Latin. So listen attentively so we sing together. Heaven and earth. Oh, give him all the glory, praise thanksgiving. The Lord is good. I can hear you. Adore and bow before the Lord and Maker. His name's Adore. Hail him, supreme in power, supreme in the Lord is good.
Chamber vocals, and we released a single. The title is Agabigalam. Agabigalam. And download it. It's on Audio Mac and all social media platforms. God bless you.
How can I truly show that? Can I reveal my heart as I am kneeling? How can I ever learn your compassion? Covered and clothed with Christ for my fashion. Turning aside a few godly sorrow. You confidently secure my tomorrow. How can I choose to live that I love you? How can I choose how I need you? Can I really share, really share what I'm feeling? Can I reveal my heart as I am kneeling? Can I truly show that I love you? How can I truly show?
How can I say
I need you? How can I really share what I'm feeling? How can I truly say?
At the foot of a rugged cross on Calvary, grace with the awesome power to set the captives free. Sustaining grace,
so much grace.
Within me, grace, I found grace. Indwelling grace, yes, I found grace. Amazing grace to meet my need. Well, I found grace at the foot of a rugged cross on Calvary. Grace with the ox of power to set the captives free.
Yeah, I found grace.
Sustaining grace.
So much grace.
Within the grace, I found grace. Indwelling grace.
Yes, I found
grace. Amazing grace to meet my need.
I sought the wisdom and the ways of this world. But no wisdom could be found. I sought the meaning in the words of great men. All the words just let me down. I started thinking for the things that I done. I saw the mercy of my father in God's.
Well, I found grace, cross on Calvary. Grace with the awesome power. Set the captives free.
Sustaining
grace.
So much grace.
Within grace, I found grace. Indwelling
grace.
Yes, I found grace. Amazing grace to meet my need.
Give up the search. It's a useless dream. You're chasing. You'll find no peace until you seek his face.
That's right.
You know the answer's right before you. At the foot of the cross, you'll find that it's a holy place. Confess your sins and lay them all down. Pick up the cross, let Jesus turn your life around. If your
grace at the foot of the cross on Calvary, grace with the awesome power. Set the captives free.
Yeah, I found grace.
Sustaining grace.
So much grace.
Grace, I found grace.
Indwelling
grace.
Yes, I found
grace. Amazing grace to meet my need.
Well, I found
grace.
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 is with the awesome power to set the captives free. Sustaining grace,
so much grace,
redeeming in grace, I found grace.
Fulfilling,
indwelling grace,
yes, I found
grace, amazing grace,
I found
grace, amazing grace,
I found
grace, amazing grace to meet my need. I found grace.
Hallelujah. Living soul, praise the Lord. Say hallelujah. One of our favorite songs, which Pastor Kelvin just introduced to us, is that God is the pillar that holds our life. If you know that God is the pillar that holds your life, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Jesus. It's a very popular Igbo song, Ngalaba. We are going to sing that song. And then we'll go to Zulu to sing the second one. Happy listening.
Ooh.
Ukolo wami, monyuka na lo, ukolo wami, monyuka, kilo.
celebration, you're going to join us in saying amen. A day will come that we shall experience an everlasting peace up there. If you believe me, ladies and gentlemen, shall we shout amen? That's awesome. Soprano, now join us, say.
good.
All the time.
All the time.
All is great.
Amen.
Amen.
This is the man of peace. And we welcome you all to the city of Abuja.
Amen.
I'd like to specially thank Pastor Kelvin Ononga. Pastor Kelvin asked, what is peace for you? For us, peace is when you are forgiven. Amen.
Amen.
Have you ever felt like giving all when you think about where you are now compared to where you used to be? If you've ever looked at where you are now and looked at where you used to be and you say, thank God, can I see your hand up? You thank God for where you are now compared to where you used to be. Now that's peace. So the song we want to sing is that no one cares like Jesus. The Lord bless you.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Smile, Jesus loves you. When I say smile, Jesus loves you, you say smile, Jesus loves you too. Smile, Jesus loves you. Wow, you are good learners. These men here are very, very, very happy. As you can see them, they are smiling. Because this is our first time to be in Nigeria. Give us a wonderful hand clap. Yes. Our next song, or our next session that we are going to do, is entitled Prayer. Prayer is one of the most significant things in a Christian life. Through prayer, we talk to our God. We tell Him all our cares and our troubles. May God bless you as you listen to these songs about prayer.
As you find your way, the Lord is life you make. I hope you live each day for all His worth. Go where your heart leads and reveal your biggest dreams. All of these things I will pray for you.
I will pray for you. I will pray for you through every darkness, through every light. This broken head of you,
I cannot
carry you, but I can promise I will pray for you.
Is to count your blessings
and not your regrets.
Next song, God sent his son.
God sent his son. They call him Jesus. He came to love. Heal and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon. An empty grave is yet to prove. My Savior lived.
Sing with me if you know this song.
Because he lived, Jesus lived. I can face tomorrow because he lived. Oh, fear is gone because I know God. Oh, he holds my future. And life is worth a living just because. Because I know.
Have you ever talked to Jesus? We talk to Jesus in very many ways. Now, this next song is entitled, Have a Little Talk to Jesus.
Was lost in sin, but Jesus took me in, and then a little light from heaven filled my soul. It bathed my heart in love and brought my name above, and just a little talk with Jesus makes me whole. Tell more about our troubles. Hear our faintest cry. Answer by and by. Feel a little prayer we're turning. No difference burning. Find a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
I may have doubts and fears. My eyes be filled with tears. But Jesus is a friend who watches day and night. I go to him in prayer. He knows my every care. And just a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
Have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our troubles.
He will.
He often just cries.
Feel a little prayer, we'll tell you, no need of fire.
Thank you so much. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you so much. Amen. Thank you so much.
God bless you.
I think we can do better for Jehovah Shalom. Let's clap for them more and more. Great guys. God bless you, Jehovah Shalom. All the way from Uganda. God bless you. God bless you. I understand we all love what they are doing, but they have a couple of CDs for us. So you can have them play in your car, in your homes, and even in your offices. And interestingly, they have about four of them. There's one titled Christ in Hymns. You have volumes 1 to 4, Hymns of the Cross. And then you have the one titled Yesu Yeka. And then you have another one, Sani Yesi. And I'm told that they are just sold at $1,500 per copy. That's cheap, isn't it? It's less than $2. So it's quite small. Amen. It's less than $2, so it's quite small. So before you leave, make sure you have a copy of at least one, and then buy another one to give someone. Amen. We also have a long list of dignitaries who are here with us, and so just try to mention your names. By the way, everyone is special, and we recognize you, and our God in heaven recognizes you. You're all welcome one more time in Jesus' name. But we have in our midst Mr. Made Enejo, who is the president of Association of Community Pharmacists here in Abuja. You are welcome, sir. We have Emeka Wogu, who is the former minister of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. You are welcome, sir. We also have the High Commissioner of the Republic of Uganda in our midst, Dr. Chega. You are welcome, sir. You are welcome, sir. I'm sure you must be very proud of your people. I also understand that there's a whole delegation from the Ugandan High Commission. Every one of you are welcome, particularly Mr. Paul Mugisha, the Chancellor. You are welcome, sir. We are glad that you are here. We have Professors Adejoke Oyewumi. You are welcome from the Faculty of Law, University of Lagos. You're welcome. We also have Professor Dorcas Odunaike. You are welcome, Faculty of Law, Babcock University. I think I should mention this to every one of us. If you want peace educating your children in Nigeria, then send them to Babcock. Amen. And so this concert is for peace. Babcock is where you have peace educating your children. We also have in our midst this evening our own president of the North Central Nigeria Conference, Pastor Micah Nasamo. You are welcome, sir. Thank you very much for being part of this event. We are glad to have you. We also have our own secretary, Pastor Amos Katia. You are welcome, sir. God bless you. Thank you for being here. We also have Pastor Riquency Muri. Pastor, you are welcome, sir. Thank you for being part of this. We are glad to have you. We also have in our midst, Otumba and Olori Shegun Runshowe, represented by the wife. Olori, you are welcome. Olori Kumbirun Shawe, you are welcome. God bless you. Thank you for being part of this program. We also have in our midst, the LTC Eroba is here. You are welcome, my Lord. God bless you. Thank you for being part of this program. And we also have in our midst, Elder Thomas Amale and wife. You are welcome. God bless you, sir. We also have Elder Lucky, Michael Lucky and wife. Thank you for being part of this event. God bless you. Amen. We'll continue to recognize our people as we have your names. But beloved, this is a very special moment of this event. This is a time when we offer prayers for peace in our nation, Nigeria, and in the world at large. As children of God, we all know that the Bible urges us to make peace, to pursue peace, in fact, with all people. And our God is a God of peace. Jesus is called the Prince of Peace. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. We all know that peace is a commodity that is very scarce in our world. The least we can do as children of God is to offer prayers for peace, not just in our country, but virtually everywhere in the world. The Bible says we should pray for the peace of Jerusalem and pray for peace within her walls. And even God told his people when they were on exile that they should seek for the peace of the land where he has caused them to be carried away captive, because it is in that peace that they themselves will have peace. And so I invite every one of God's children, those inside, those outside, and those with the backs, please, you may just take action now. This is a solemn moment so that we can unite in faith as we offer these petitions to our God for peace. So those sharing the backs, I plead with you to please stay action for now until we are done offering these prayers. Everyone outside, join us right here in the hall. This is a very solemn moment. May I now invite pastors Ibrahim Meigadi and Ishaya Estefanus. These two men of God will lead us in this petition for peace. You're welcome, sir.
Before the prayer, there are guidelines that we will suggest. Please, if you have a little noisy environment, we suggest, please, let's have a quiet moment. And if you have your cell phone, if you can't off it, let it be on vibrations. You don't on your phone while communicating with God is ongoing. We suggest let's put these cell phones off and noise, let's minimize it. As we request, we humbly bow our heads while I will kneel here, or we kneel here. Let's bow our heads, moments for prayer. We would like to give praise, to thank God who gave life. Thank you for blessing this country. Oh Lord, there is a lot we need to thank you, because as a country, this is 62 years old, we are existing as a nation, sovereign nation. Thank you for giving us a country where God passes every day from the four corners of this country. We praise your name, O Lord. In spite of the challenges, we live as a country. We praise you, O God. In spite of the difficulties, Nigeria is not divided. We praise you, O Lord. We would like to request, our sinful propensities and nature have dwarfed so many things and carried a lot of things away. We wish to plead and seek for forgiveness from heaven. May the Lord help us that we can act aright and divert the wrath of God for this country. And that's why we kneel. Sin has divided and separated us from God. Sin has separated us from one another. And we'd like to pray specifically for unity for this country, for peace that we have heard from the message from the morning to divine service and even the closing benediction or devotion. Thank you for echoing. Peace can only be gotten from you. And we request, may the Lord come and lead while we follow. Lead that our leaders will follow. From the presidency, we are praying for our head of state. May the Lord fill him with fear and the love of God. May the Lord endow him with patience, patience to bear with the excess of things he hears. It is very, very easy to talk about wrongs, but it is difficult to handle leadership. It is sophisticated, and we are praying for our dear head of state, General Retired Muhammadu Buhari, and his deputies. We would like to pray for the governors, 36 of them, and we'd like to pray for the judiciary. May the Lord fill them with fear and wisdom that they will act with justice, fairness, love, and mercy towards the citizens of this country. We wish to pray for the senators, for the legislators, and for the security agencies. So many of them have lost their lives. Father, we pray, may the Lord lead and encourage and protect those in the military and paramilitary. In a country where we are even attacking them rather than supporting and praying for them, we are just simply kneeling to pray for the military and paramilitary and the civilian, so many innocent that have we supposed to protect, they have become ravages where we attack left and right on defenseless and innocent citizens. May the Lord protect our citizens. We kneel to pray and ask the Lord to remember the election that will come. No one knows who will be who, and it is not given to us to read the minds to know what will happen. Our minds are blank and empty, and we depend on God to choose leaders that will lead this country for us. And you are the one that can make the difference, O Lord. You are the first, you are the best, and you are the last hope of mankind. May the Lord grant that this country will live an exemplary life where we will campaign, we will conduct election peacefully, and then finish and say, yes, the Lord has chosen for us credible leaders. May it be so as we pray. In Jesus' name.
O God, our help in ages past and our hope for years to come. We kneel down before your majesty. We bow our heads in total submission to your will, appreciating you for this great weekend. Thank you for this wonderful program, a program that has called us together from different parts of the world to ask and pray for the peace of our nations. Thank you, O Lord, for this great opportunity. We ask today, as we lift up unto your throne of mercy, the diplomats that are in this country and other parts of the world. They have left their fatherlands to be in various countries as they represent their fatherlands. We ask, O Lord, that you envelop them with your protection as they serve their country in various countries. May you abide with them and grant them wisdom. As they discharge their duties, may they do it to the glory of your name and to the betterment of their countries. We ask for their family members, their wives and their children. You are the only one who can protect. You are the only one who can bring peace. Abide with them, O God, and fill them with the power of thy Holy Spirit. In the communities where they live as diplomats, we ask that your security will abide with them. May your angels watch over them and be on guard on a daily basis, that as they finish their work here and other parts of the countries, as they go back to their homelands, let them go back in peace and rejoice that mission is accomplished. We ask, O Lord, this evening, and lifting up before you the continent of Africa. Thank you for making us Africans, a land that flows with milk and honey, a land that has mineral resources, human resources. The list could go. Thank you because it is not a mistake for us to be part and parcel of this continent. We appreciate you, O Lord. Thank you for Africa. We pray you speak peace in the country of Africa. In countries where there is unrest and no peace, Ethiopia, we pray for Mali. We pray for Burkina Faso. We pray for Sudan. And so many countries that the least could go. We ask that you speak your peace in such countries. That you bring everlasting peace. For the sake of the gospel, O Lord, we ask that you speak peace to those countries. Speak peace to our country, Nigeria, because this is where we belong. We have no other place than this. So we ask that in the east, in the west, in the south, and north, you will speak peace to this great nation. We ask, O Lord, and intercede on behalf of Ukraine. It's a country that is passing through a lot of challenges. We ask, O Lord, that even in the midst of this great challenge, may they have peace. Just like Jesus spoke peace to the boisterous sea, may your peace be in Ukraine. Visit them in a special way, O God, and protect your children. Protect men and women, young people, and old people. We ask, O Lord, that you do this to the honor and glory of your name. We pray for the world at large. 7 continents make up the world: Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Europe, Antarctica, and others. We ask, O Lord, that you envelop us with your peace. Envelop us with your peace for the sake of the gospel. Hold the stripes of wings that we will be able to accomplish the mission given in our hands. Thank you, blessed Lord, for your mercies and your grace. Help us to have the mind which was in Jesus Christ. Even though he was equal with God, he humbled himself, tolerated us to make peace between us and God. May peace visit each and every one of us. May peace start with us today. May peace reflect in our homes. May peace reflect in our communities. May peace reflect in our countries. May peace reflect in our continent. Thank you for hearing us, O God. We pray these and other blessings in faith and in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. At this time, we will have a 5-minute intermission, during which time the orchestra will play.
Thank you very much, the orchestra. Thank you for that beautiful interlude. The next segment of this concert will be featuring the following groups. We have Kenai, we have Spring Notes, we have Advent Vocal, we have the Rising, and then again we'll have Jehovah Shalom. Amen. So they are going to be here in that order. First, we are going to now invite the Kenai to take the stage.
Oh yes, I know him. His wonderful peace coming down from the Savior above. And when he says peace, be still, the winds and the waves, they have to
can't express how much you've done for me.
Praise you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise you all my days. Words cannot express how much you've done for me. Praise you, Lord my God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, you're worthy.
We bring you the first ministration from the northern part of Nigeria, where Adventism began, to be precise, Jingri. The song is titled Ikubu. What will you gain when you gain the whole world and lose heaven? Which transcends to our second ministration, which we will all be expecting the second coming of Jesus Christ. Be blessed.
Weri fe mother to ikubesa kilari kane ikubuwe ikubu namaku mula usuwe ameku weri fe mother to ikubesa kilari kane ikubu. Mutu bindaya ke soro
to sai babu ko darajane oh kai kai jinkirin bin yesu ko zakasha uya ikubuwe
namaku
ikubuwe
usuwe namasu ameku Ikubesa kila rikane
Ti maso nanya ni kubasa kutele Yane rimani tu ti boni We refe maga tu Ikubesa kila rikane Kimi kane Keeping on Kutale Awanyabara Kelen Arikitin So We're in Femarutu Ikubesa Kilarikane Ikubuwe
Ikubunamaku
Ikubunamaku
Ikubunamaku Ikubunamaku Ikubunamaku
Amen.
feeling tonight? What greater way to express our joy than to celebrate the grace of God upon our lives?
Amen.
The grace of God is peace. It grants us happiness. It grants us freedom indeed. May the Lord bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Yeah.
Again, this is another session. Now, people have been wondering who is singing, which voice, you know. They're asking very many questions. Of course, this is Jehovah Shalom a cappella. And now, without wasting time, let me introduce myself. I'm Twin Waswa. Waswa Amos. Can you clap for me? And now, if you love twins, I'm Twin Waswa is Twin Kato. And if mom is watching us from Uganda, we love you so much, mama.
Love you so much, mama.
Is Twin Kato. Kato, can you say, what do you have to say to the audience?
Hallelujah. The best.
In what can wash away my sins?
Nothing but the
blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again today, and again today?
Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
Everything together.
Can you sing that chorus?
Oh, precious is the flow.
I don't hear you.
That makes me white.
That makes me white.
Is going to sing the next stanza. What do we say, ladies and gentlemen? Can you give a man to the pastor? Okay. The next stanza. Can we sing the chorus that we can give him that vibe, okay?
Oh, precious is the flow.
You could repeat the first verse.
The first verse, okay. What can wash away?
What can wash away my sin?
Together.
Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
What can make me whole again?
Nothing but the
a wonderful heart love. Let's sing together.
Oh, precious is the flow.
Wave your hand. That makes me well.
That makes
me. I don't see your hand.
Oh, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Now, how many of you will reach in heaven by show of hands? And when you reach in heaven, what will you do? What? Okay, bro, sir, what will you do when you reach in heaven?
I will enjoy myself.
Wow. Okay, another opportunity here comes this side. I want to ask someone who has been here and has been enjoying the music for a while. What will you do when you reach in heaven?
I'll sing beautiful songs with you.
Wow.
Bro.
Yes.
First come here.
Yes, sir.
You've not introduced this gentleman.
Okay.
And he's a very important person.
And after introducing, we sing.
Okay.
All of us.
Okay.
And now, I was coming to introduce him. And then, okay, these are twins. Of course, when you look at him, okay, introduce yourself first.
Now you are introducing me.
I have to introduce you.
Yes, finish.
And now when you see twins here, and this is our younger brother.
I come after this gentleman.
Can you add him another wonderful hand clap? Yeah. And what are your names, sir?
Yes, my name is Elijah Chagulanyi, and I'm so honored to be here. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
And what do you have?
Okay.
And now, these are twins, so we are trios here. Okay? Then, there is another twin. Can you introduce yourself, sir?
Waswa James, and God bless you.
Hope you noticed, this is Waswa. I'm Waswa. Is Kato, and the younger brother is called Chiza. Can you repeat after me? Chiza.
Chiza.
Right. You're good. You're good students. Okay. Now, after twins, we have our grandfather.
Yes.
This is our grandfather. Sir, introduce yourself, sir, grandfather.
Okay. My name is Joseph Luima. I sing baritone.
You sing baritone. Okay, thank you very much for coming and for performing well. Then we have and this is Mr. Sembubu Asaf.
Gloria.
And is a married man. Send greetings to your wife, sir.
All right, my dear sweetheart, wherever you are, please. I love you.
Okay, what do you do here in this group? What do you do?
Well, in this group, Jehovah Shalom, I do bass and beatboxing. Now, this is what we call beatboxing.
I don't hear you. Can you add him another wonderful hand clap? Wow. Mr. Sembu Buasaf, you're lucky. And I know your wife is very happy now. May God bless you. I was telling you, let me start from where I stopped. I said, how many of you will sing a cappella in heaven? With your voice, are we together? So we believe when we reach in heaven, we shall sing a cappella. But what is a cappella, grandfather?
A cappella means voices without musical instruments.
Voices without musical instruments.
Yes.
The song. Amen. We're going to sing together in Jesus' name. Amen.
When we reach heaven, we shall sing a cappella.
As simple as that.
When we reach heaven,
we shall sing a cappella.
Okay, now we are going to increase the speed, the velocity.
When we reach
we shall sing a cappella.
We aim to reach there in the city bright and fair. When we reach heaven, we shall sing a cappella. We aim to reach there in the city bright and fair. When we reach heaven,
oh, oh, we shall sing a cappella.
We aim to reach, we aim to reach there
in the city bright and fair.
A cappella,
we shall sing a cappella.
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 We're gonna shout, shout, we're gonna sing, sing, we're gonna shout, shout. When we reach, we shall sing a cappella, a cappella.
We're gonna sing, sing, we're gonna shout, we're gonna sing, sing, we're gonna shout. When we reach, we shall sing a cappella. We're gonna sing, sing, we're gonna shout,
la la la.
We're gonna shout.
Thank you so much. You. May God bless you.
Amen. It's been a very wonderful evening in the presence of the Lord. We want to use this privilege to say a very big thank you to everyone that has been part of this International Peace Concert 2 from morning even till this moment. It is not easy, but we want to thank you in a special way. That you are here, you made it possible. Thank you so much for being part of the International Peace Concert 2 2022. I'd like to use this little time to appreciate every one of us, especially our invited guests, our friends that took time out of their busy schedules to be here this evening. We pray that the Lord shall bless you richly and abundantly. In a special way, we want to appreciate our guest speaker, Professor Kelvin Ononga, the Vice Chancellor of the Adventist University of Central Africa in Rwanda. Thank you, Professor Kelvin. He just stepped out. He has been with us since on Thursday. He was part of the peace conference yesterday, and today again, he was the guest speaker in the morning and the keynote speaker this evening. Thank you so much, and we pray that the Lord will bless you and grant you joining mercies. Want to say a very big thank you to our father, our royal father, His Majesty, the Bongom Joss, Elder Jacob Gyambuba. Let's give him a round of applause, please. It is not easy to leave your kingdom to another place. Thank you so much for coming. We appreciate you a lot with Mommy Ongo. Thank you so much for your support and prayers. When we visited him at the palace, he wasn't so sure of being here. He had other engagement, but because of his love and support as a father, thank you so much. We are encouraged richly by your presence. The Lord bless and keep you for us.
We also want to appreciate our professors. We have a team of them from Babcock University and the University of Lagos. Professor Dorcas, thank you so much. She was the anchor of our peace conference yesterday. And our mommy too, the professor from UNILAC, I didn't get the name, sorry. Thank you so much for honoring this invitation. She was too very busy, but made it to be part of this event at the dying minute. Thank you so much. We appreciate our diplomatic community. In a special way, we want to appreciate the Deputy High Commissioner of Uganda. He is here in person with the PA. Thank you so much, sir, for coming. We appreciate you and your support. We also thank every other person. We have other diplomatic corps, Tanzania, we have Namibia, we have Angola. Thank you so much for being part of this event. Thank you, and the Lord bless and keep you. We will not fail to appreciate our spiritual fathers, the conference president and secretary, the union executive secretary, Pastor Ishaya Estefanus. Thank you for your support. Thank you for your prayers. Thank you for your fatherly advice. Without you, we wouldn't have come this far. We appreciate your prayers. We appreciate your support in every special way. Not failing to say thank you to Ambassador Solomon Jere, the former High Commissioner of Zambia. He has been with us online. Thank you so much. And we appreciate your support. We also want to thank our friends from Nigeria Proclaim Project, Elder Akiwumi and Elder Emeka Ukebu from Dallas, United States. Thank you for your support. Thank you for your prayers. And we hope to continue in this partnership together. Not failing to say a very great thank you to Jehovah Shalom, all the way from Uganda. Another round of applause for this great man. Thank you for honoring this invitation, coming down to Nigeria for the very first time, and we know that when next we extend such an invitation, you will not relent, you shall honor our invitation and be part of this great event. We want to say thank you to all our ministering group, the Advent Vocals from Jos, Chamber Vocals, Risen, Solomon Singers, Men of Peace, Insika Lois, Kinai, Soul Max. Thank you so much for being part of the International Peace Concert number 2. In a special way, I want to say thank you to Axios Choir. Thank you for your sacrifice and your dedication. Though they had challenge on their way coming, they were short, they had issues, but within themselves, they raised the funds to finish this journey. Thank you so much for this dedication and sacrifice. And we want to assure you that so long as the International Peace Concert remains, you will continually be a part of this stage. We appreciate your support. And we pray that the Lord will bless you as you return back home. I will not fail but to appreciate the Asokoro Seventh-day Adventist Church for working together as a team to have this event continually. Thank you especially to the planning committee. We had sleepless night. Sometimes we traveled. We had a tire burst on one of our journeys. Thank you so much for your dedication. Thank you for your sacrifice. And every other person that have supported us. Thank you, Yusuf Damadami. Thank you, Musa. Thank you, everyone, for being part of the International Peace Concert. Our ushers did little by sharing our token of appreciation to our invited guests. In case you didn't get one, as you leave the hall, we have wonderful tokens of appreciation. They are books, spiritual literatures that will help you in your spiritual life. So as you leave, please do well to pick a hamper outside, a paper bag outside containing these literatures. And I know as you read them, as you study them, you will have the innermost peace that you desire in your life. I will not fail, but appreciate I am with a small I, because we have the only one I am that I am. They are just I am. The media company that have put this together, let's give them a round of applause. I am, you have not failed us. The investment was worth it, and we pray that the Lord will bless you, Valentine and Tim. Thank you for working together with Asokoro Seventh-day Adventist Church. By the way, the Seventh-day Adventist Church in Northern Nigeria, this year, 2022, will be celebrating 90 years of existence in Northern Nigeria. And so we want to tell you that this church, the Seventh-day Adventist Church, is here to stay. It has been in existence, and it shall continue to be in existence, preparing the way for the soon coming of Christ our Savior. As we leave, the Jehovah Shalom have their CDs. It has been announced. They are out there. Please get copy that you can continue to remember this event. Axios Choir also have their CDs and other groups. So they are out just for a token. As you go there, I believe you will have one or two to share with your friends. To all our friends that came from Nyanya Massacre Axis, we have buses outside that will convey you free. You don't have to wait for a long. Please join these buses. We also have a bus going towards Kubwa. We have a bus going towards the airport road. So please, these buses are free. They are meant for you. The Lord be with you as you return to your home safely. I would like to end with words of blessings, with words of thanksgiving unto the Lord. And I want to invite every one of us to bow our heads as we say thank you to Jehovah, thank you to our Father, as he bestows upon us his grace and his peace, in the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good night, and God bless you. We hope to see you again in 2023 for International Peace Concert Season 3. It will be taking place on the 14th of October 2023 in this same auditorium. The Lord bless you. See you in 2023. Good night, and God bless you. And God bless you.
Amen. Just before we leave, ladies and gentlemen, we have a cake here to cut so that we can celebrate the event properly. And so I'll plead with you to please take your seat, if you don't mind, so we can cut this cake and then share it to the audience. May I now, with the greatest respect, invite the following persons to join me here as we cut this cake. May I now invite Pastor Mike Anasamu to please join me here. Pastor Anasamu, the President North Central Nigeria Conference, please join me. Let me also invite Edavibi Nabasu, please join us. Join us here for the cutting of the cake. That is the high point of this program. Eda Nabasu, please join me, sir. Pastor Mike Anasamu, join me here. Mrs. Tina Kwaskebe, please join me. Eda Loke, Michael Loke, I saw you somewhere in the hall, please. Eda Loke, join me to also cut the cake. Eda Loke, Michael Loke, please join me. And then we also have Romano Thomas, representing the Asokoro Church. Romano Thomas, please join us here to cut the cake. Then we also have Professor Gaius Umahi. Professor Gaius Umahi, join us. Join us so that we can cut the International Peace Concert cake. Professor Gaius Umahi, are you here? Okay, you're welcome, sir. Eda Chidawa, is he here? Eda Abed Chidawa, is he here? Please join us so that we can cut the cake together, and then that wraps it. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time to now cut the cake. So we are going to go when we say IBC 2022, and then they will do the cutting. And so let's stretch our hands to the knife. Let's stretch our hands to the knife. So let's say I. Let's say P. Let's say C. And 2022. Amen. Thank you very much. A round of applause for them. Thank you very much. Thank you. We are grateful. Thank you for this role you have played. God bless you. God bless you. Please, the Jehovah Shalom, we take the stage now to keep singing, which what we call the musical epilogue. That will continue. So don't be in a hurry to go. You can still have some moments with Jehovah Shalom. Those who need their CDs, please meet Dasa Nwokoma. He has them. You can just buy and have your copies. Oh, I'm just told that it's exhausted. We'll make arrangement for us to have more. For those who still need it, we will lay eyes with them to see that you get it. Thank you very much for being part of the IPC 2022. The Lord will preserve each one of us, and then we'll see you again in this same venue, just as it has been announced. As you go, may the Lord lead you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, and thank you again. God bless you. We have a missing item. If you have a missing item, please do let us know. We have it in our custody. There is a wallet and there's an ATM card in it. Please just let us know if it belongs to you. Come for identification and collection. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Jehovah Shalom, this is your time for the epilogue. God bless you. Good night.
Can you add him another wonderful hand clap? And what are your names, sir?
Yes, my name is Elijah Chagulani, and I'm so honored to be here. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
James, and God bless you.
Hope you noticed this is Waswa. I'm Waswa, he's Kato, and the younger brother is called Chiza. Can you repeat after me? Chiza. Right. You're good. You're good students. Okay. Now, after twins, we have our grandfather.
Yes.
This is our grandfather. Sir, introduce yourself, sir, grandfather.
Okay, my name is Joseph Luyima. I sing baritone.
You sing baritone. Okay. Thank you very much for coming and for performing well. Then we have and this is Mr. Sembubu Asaf.
Glory.
And is a married man. Send greetings to your wife, sir.
Right, my dear sweetheart, wherever you are, please. I love you.
Okay, what do you do here in this group? What do you do?
Well, in this group, Jehovah Shalom, I do bass and beatboxing. Now, this is what we call beatboxing.
Can you add him another wonderful hand clap? Wow. Mr. Sembubu Asaf, you're lucky. And I know your wife is very happy now. May God bless you. I was telling you, let me start from where I stopped. I said, how many of you will sing a cappella in heaven? With your voice, are we together? So we believe when we reach in heaven, we shall sing a cappella. But what is a cappella, grandfather?
A cappella means voices without musical instruments.
Voices without musical instruments. Okay.
We reach heaven.